8 years ago, this is how my skin used to look like. I had a lot of breakouts, especially on my cheeks and on my chin, and I used to pick up my pimples, so that led to a lot of scarring in those problem areas. Fast forward to now, this is how my skin looks like. I am not wearing foundation or blush because I don't like makeup. I don't like the feeling of having something on my skin. There's still room for improvement, but I think it looks pretty good as compared to back then. Hello, it's Janetta. If you're new here, thank you for stopping by. If you're already a subscriber, welcome back. Today, I want to share some skincare tips for oily and acne-prone skin. But before we start, let me just mention that this video is not about promoting a specific product or a holy grail. Rather, I want to share with you the two major changes that I made several years ago in order to improve the health of my skin and to give you some pointers on what you might want to change today. So the first major change that I made was to improve my diet. We've all heard the saying, you are what you eat, and we're probably sick of hearing it, but it is so true. What you put into your body is just as important, if not more so, than what you put on your skin. You want to start by improving your skin from the inside out. I did not start improving my diet with the expressed aim of improving my skin, but rather I just wanted to live a healthier lifestyle. And eventually I noticed that my skin was improving dramatically as a result. So the changes that I made in order to eat a more healthy diet were to cut down on red meat. I've never really been a big meater anyways, but I cut down to the point where I was only having red meat maybe only once every other week or once every month. I also cut down a lot on my sugar intake to the point where I almost didn't need to buy sugar anymore because I was no longer adding it to tea or coffee. I was hardly ever buying fizzy drinks. Apparently, sugar and refined carbs can lead to premature wrinkling and aging skin. So if you're somebody who tends to consume a lot of sugar in the form of, like, fizzy drinks and or baked goods and processed food, and then you're experiencing skin problems, then that might be an area that you'd want to look into and see whether your skin will respond in a more positive way. So alongside reducing meat and sugar, I increased how much fruits and vegetables I was eating. I especially increased my intake of superfoods such as leafy greens and healthy fats like avocados, nuts, and seeds. I initially started drinking a lot of green smoothies. There was a point where I was having green smoothies for breakfast every single day, and then I cut down to just a couple of times a week. I also made sure to drink enough water every single day. Not getting enough water can really lead to your skin looking dull and so on. I've been drinking at the very, very least 1 liter of water a day. Usually, I average between 1.5 to 2 liters every single day in order to stay hydrated. So, in summary, I just made sure to eat a more balanced diet, to eat more home cooked meals, to cooking from scratch, to reducing processed foods, my sugar, and to make sure that I continuously stay hydrated. The second major change that I made was to ditch conventional beauty products. As I did more and more research into oily and acne-prone skin and the different factors that tend to influence our skin's health, I realized that a lot of the drugstore conventional beauty products that I was using were really not helping me. So I researched and made a complete switch to natural products, switching out every single item in my skincare to natural alternatives. So do you know that a lot of the facial cleansers are actually quite harsh? They work by stripping the protective oils from your skin. So after you wash your face, you get that squeaky clean feeling and you're happy because all the oil from your face is gone. But actually what happens is that your skin starts overproducing oil to compensate for the fact that too much oil has been taken from your skin, and that overproduction of oils then leads to further breakouts. So it's kind of a vicious cycle. So now more gentle and natural cleansers work to break that cycle so your skin can regulate its oil production to the point where it no longer overproduces oil. When I first made the switch to natural alternatives, I initially started with Moroccan rasool clay and oil, and then eventually also added African black soap. If you want to know about the products that I use, make sure to check out this video. I will include a link in the description box. If you also want to know how to choose the right oil for your particular skin type so you can incorporate oil into your skincare routine, whether as a cleanser or as a moisturizer, make sure to watch this particular video I have also included the link in the description box below. Please know that no two skin types are the same. Even if we both have oily or acne prone skin, yours may be more sensitive than mine. I may react better to pumpkin seed oil versus grapeseed oil, even though they're both good for oily skin. So I encourage you to do your research and to find out how different natural skincare products are likely to affect your skin before you try them out. If you have any questions, leave them down in the description box. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.